Mr. True, in this video, we're going to do a fun little problem that is probably in your pre-calculus book. We are going to write the area of this triangular region A as a function of lowercase a and then determine the domain of that function. This is a wonderful example of why it is important when you think about mathematics and going through your journey in algebra and calculus and whatnot that keep it simple. Remember the basics. We are being asked to create an equation that defines the area of this triangular region. Well, the vertical and horizontal leg of this right triangle is on the y and x axis, and we have a hypotenuse that is defined by a line. Now, it wouldn't seem like you're going to need to write the equation of a line when you have a problem that says, you know, to create an equation for area. But this is an excellent setup for the type of problem you're going to see in calculus that involves usually optimization, where they'll give you something like this and say, you know, find the slope of the line that maximizes the area of the triangle or something to that effect. It's also a really good problem because it's a reminder that when you are learning mathematics, every tool that you learn needs to stay in your toolbox, you know, cleaned up, oiled, not getting rusty, and ready to go at any moment's notice. Because here the problem says write the area of, create an area formula. So let's start with that and see where this idea of coming up with an equation of a line is involved in this problem. Because, hey, what's the area of that, oh, I should use blue, of this blue region? Well, it's a triangle. And the area of a triangle, while there are, you know, a few versions of it, the most common area formula that we work with is that area is equal to 1/2 the base times the height of the triangle. Okay, that's good. As I look over here in my diagram and I try and think of how I'm going to start this problem, I'm continually going back to the directions and it says write the area of A as a function of lowercase a. So as I look at this triangle, this right triangle, I have a base which I do not know the exact length, but we're writing an equation, a function, which gives the basically the area of any right triangle that's in quadrant one, where the legs are the x and y axis, and whose hypotenuse passes through the point of 2, 1. But this isn't necessarily the shape of that triangle. We could have the line going through the point 2, 1 and maybe creating a triangle sort of in that shape, or a triangle that is looks maybe something more like this, or a triangle that maybe has a longer hypotenuse still passing through the point 2, 1 and maybe the x-intercept is getting a little bit closer to 2. So we don't know the base and the height of that triangle specifically, but we do have, from the origin, we have the x-intercept of this line identified as with the coordinate of a 0, and the y-coordinate, the y-intercept of that line defining the hypotenuse defined with the coordinate of 0, b. Well, that would make the area of this triangle equal to 1/2 the length of the base, and along the bottom here, from the origin to the coordinate of a 0, we have an unknown distance of a. And then the height of the triangle from the origin, we go up to the y-intercept of that line, so we have a, well, an unknown value of b, which seems a little bit confusing because I have b registered, written there as the base, but right now we have the area of this triangle is 1/2 a times b. Well, this is a function, this is a formula for the area region A, the area of this triangle. This is an area formula as a function of A and B, or this is area in terms of A and B. And our problem says write a A as a function of A. You want an area formula in terms of A, not in terms of A and B. So we need to find a way of getting rid of this variable of B in our equation. How are we going to do that? Right now we have an equation of any right triangle that is in quadrant one of the xy coordinate system, where the horizontal leg has a length of a and the vertical length leg has a length of b. We have nowhere in this current formula incorporated the idea that the hypotenuse has to pass through the coordinate of 2, 1. Okay, so now we're getting into that idea of like, we need to write the equation of a line. We need a line that defines the hypotenuse that passes through the fixed point of 2, 1, and we can either use the coordinate of 2, 1 and 0, b to come up with the equation of the line, or we can use the coordinate of 2, 1 and the coordinate of a, b. Well, again, we want an area as a function of a. We want the independent variable to be a, not b. So the rest of this problem, we're going to be focusing on working with the coordinate of a, 0, that x-intercept. Again, that hypotenuse is a yellow line. At least that's what I'm going to focus on. What do you need to write the equation of a line? A point and a slope. Now, this is a pretty hard problem, but the core fundamentals of how you work this out will not change. This is the same process that we would do if I gave you 2 points like 1, 3 and 2, 7 and said find the equation of the line that passes through those 2 points. Just because one of these points has an unknown value of a or a variable doesn't change how we're going to work through this problem. We have a given point of 2, 1. Now we have 2 points, that's great, but we need a point and a slope. We have to figure out a slope that represents this original dark, thick, yellow line segment that I gave us in the first place. Arguably, it could be anywhere, but we want to focus on that. So, slope is, let's see, let's call this x sub 1, y sub 1, and the coordinate of a 0, x sub 2, y sub 2. So, we have y sub 2 is 0 minus y sub 1, which is equal to 1. And now I see I have a numerator, which is negative 1, so I wish I had swapped the order of these labels, but I'm going to stick with it. Over x sub 2, which is a, minus x sub 1, which is 2. So the slope of that line, this yellow line that has a y-intercept of b and an x-intercept of a that passes through the point 2, 1, has a slope which is equal to negative 1 over a minus 2. If a student or you were to label this as x sub 2, y sub 2, no, yes, and x sub 1, y sub 1, well, then your slope would be and kind of like me factoring negative 1 out of the numerator and denominator would be 1 over 2 minus a. Those are equivalent expressions. So now we have a point, 2, 1, and we have a slope of 1 over 2 minus a. And when you have a point and a slope, you can write the equation of a line starting with the point-slope form of a line. Point-slope form of a line is y minus y sub 1 is equal to m times x minus x sub 1. And we're going to plug in that y value of 1 from our given point. The slope that we had to find on our own, 1 minus 2 over a. Excuse me, yeah, 1 over 2 minus a. Times x minus x sub 1, the x-coordinate of our value is 2. Okay, now, that's great. What do we need from the equation of this line? Going back to the purpose of the question, the question said, write the area of the triangular region A, the right triangle A, and we have a base of A. We were doing all of this work for writing the equation of a line that defines the hypotenuse of the triangle so that from that line we could find b. We can find the height of that triangle. If the line's really, you know, kind of stretched out, if a is really far out, maybe the height is very small. If a is getting closer to something, we're going to talk about the domain, maybe that triangle gets really, really tall. We don't know how tall that triangle is, but we do know that the height of that triangle is going to be defined by the y-intercept of that hypotenuse. So we have the equation of a line, granted it's got a lot of variables in it, but that represents that line with a variable slope, how do we find a y-intercept? What is equal to zero when you're looking for a y-intercept? What's equal to zero is x. If you want to find a y-intercept, you let x equal zero. So now I'm going to pick a different color here just so to kind of define it. We're going to find that y-intercept by letting x equal zero, meaning that we're going to have y minus 1 is equal to 1 over 2 minus a times, I'm setting x equal to 0, so 0 minus 2. And see, now if I had worked with the negative 1 over a minus 2, I would have a negative 1 times negative 2, and that negative that kind of bothered me here would have gone away. That's the joy of doing these kind of problems and having flex, you know, and enjoying the journey. We have negative 2, because that's going to be over 1. So negative 2 times 1 is negative 2 over 2 minus a. We're going to add both sides by 1. Of course, that means we're going to need a common denominator. So what we really have is y minus 1 is equal to negative 2 over 2 minus a. This plus 1 is going to need to be written as plus 2 minus a over 2 minus a. We need a common denominator, right? And that's just 1. Anything divided by itself is 1. And then we have, I added the 1 over to the other side. Let me try that again. So now we have y is equal to negative 2 plus 2 is going to be 0. So minus a over 2 minus a. And let me just make sure, because sometimes I do make small mistakes. So my y-intercept checks out, which means that we can say, now I said y equals, but this isn't just a regular value of y, it is the y-intercept, which means that we have b. We know the vertical height of the right triangle. So we have, now we can take out b and say that the area of that triangular region as a function of a is going to be equal to 1 half a times b, which is negative a over 2 minus a, giving us a final answer of a times negative a is negative a squared over 2 times 2, distributing that 2 in the denominator to the 2 minus a in the denominator. 2 times 2 is 4 minus 2a, and that is how we take our core concepts that we know of how to write the area of a triangle and how to write the equation of a line, knowing that we need a minimum of point and slope, and tackle a pretty tough question like this, where we read something, it looks like geometry, and it is area of a triangle, but yet in the middle, we need to realize that we need to make a connection to another math concept that we either have recently learned or have learned a while ago and we're reviewing. And that is the end of my example. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework. Or wait to finish your homework. I never answered the rest of my question. What's the domain of this function? If I take a negative 1 and factor it out of the denominator, 4 divided by negative 1 is negative 4, and negative 2a divided by negative 1 is 2a, and now I can let these negative coefficient of a squared and the negative factor of negative 1 in front of those parentheses and have another form, which may be what you see in the back of a textbook as a solution because there's less negatives involved, a squared over 2a minus 4. But now, what is the domain? The domain for A, now you have A showing up in the denominator, so you might think, hey, I'm just going to set the denominator equal to 0 and find out what makes the denominator of this equation equal to 0. But this is not just a purely algebraic problem. It is tied to geometry, and while I didn't write it, A has to be, it's defined as a triangular region. we need A, region A, to be a right triangle with those legs on the x and y axis and a hypotenuse. and have an enclosed area. So how far back can I bring this coordinate of A and still create a triangle? I'm looking around, actually don't have a little, looking for a little ruler or something. If I bring this A back to a point where it's actually equal to 2, if I let A equal 2 and I go through the point of 2, 0, I'm going to have, well, now I have two red lines, but I'm going to end up with a vertical line segment. That's not going to form a right triangle sort of in that corner of the quadrant 1. And I certainly can't let A be something like, you know, less than 2, like 1, because then you're going to have a triangle that just kind of shoots off into space, and you're not going to enclose the right triangle, you know, in that lower left-hand corner of quadrant 1. So the domain of this function is not just this function, the area as a function of A, which is A squared over 2A minus 4, is not just setting the denominator equal to 0 and finding out what can you not divide by. It's the fact that you have to create a triangle. So our domain for this problem, this area formula, is that A has to be such that it is greater than 2 and less than infinity, or you can write it as an inequality notation, A is greater than 2. Now I'm done. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.